So this video shows how to flash those Turnigy Plush NFET 30 amp ESCs. We can either rip this thing apart completely and solder wires on it. That's what we see here with those three programming pins. Or we use a Dremel and we cut this thing open on top of the pins. That's what I did here. First attempt, I was not deep enough. You can't go too deep, then you damage parts inside, but I got step by step closer and closer to the truth. I have to get all those four pins accessible. So when I'm done with it and cleaning everything inside, then I have those three holes. Let's zoom out a little bit and then we see how that looks like. So basically there is this little hole there and I put a label on it and this thing is closed again. Now I use pogo pin adapters. Pogo pins, they have a little spring in there and have gold contacts. I made this thing myself. Those I can poke in there and hold them over the contacts while I program. There we can see this. That's how I program the Silabs F330 chip there. Now, I need a developer tool, a Silabs Toolstick, that comes with an extension cord, USB extension cord. Then the toolstick base itself, that's the toolstick. That's how it looks like. I need to modify it. So we open up the package and solder the black and red wire to those two pins, ground and C2K. This is one of the programming pins. On the other side, we need to add another wire. So it's orange in my case. Orange wire there, and where it says blob, those two pins have to be shortened. Like there, I put a little blob of soldering stuff on there, and that's how it looks like my programming thing, my programming adapter. Okay, so I have my tool stick connected to the USB of the computer. We see here the little green light is on. And so those three wires I have soldered to the stick. I use those. And those I can either connect to my little pogo pin adapter here, or I can solder cables onto the ESC and plug it in here. So then, for demonstration purposes, basically I don't have to hold the stick, so I have one hand available. So I'm going to plug this in, and then I also power up the ESC with a battery. So here's my setup now. USB to the stick, plugged in here, soldered to those pins, and powered up to the battery. All on, and then I'm gonna go and look into the software. Alright, so there's two ways to flash this. If I open the Silabs Flash Tool, then I will see that automatically it finds the USB stick, the tool stick. I can push the connect button, it has to update it. There it goes, and then I see the versions down here, the tool stick versions, right? Then I go to the download folder, I select my file I want. This is the file for my stick, a hex file, right? I can erase all the data on the ESC before I flash, and then the download button basically downloads the data to the ESC chip. It's successful, it has a checksum, so it was good. You can verify the download and it will show you it's okay. Alright, and then you can cancel this thing out, and there we have it. The second method is to use the BLHeli software. Since you need this thing anyway, if you want to do the settings later, you might as well flash with it. So it automatically recognizes the tool stick. You write connect, and then you can read the setup. here, read setup, and then you see what software version you have. So it has 11.1, and I have already the hex file for 13.2. So I can say flash it, I can select what I want here. Latest is 13.2. That's what I want. The multicopter version. Perfect. I say OK, and I say OK, yes, do it. It updates, flashes, checksum, everything successful, so that's it. I say no here because I want to look at my settings. I can read my current setup. And this is all the settings for this ESC, so I can change if I want. When I click the house button, so if there's a little house button on the side, then this is the default setting. Right, so I can play around here, do all the settings I want. and if I want to write my setup, I have to click the write my setup button. So we could name this thing, for example, motor 1. And then write setup. It's okay, everything is okay always. And if we push read, then it reads it out again. Yeah, everything successful. We see how the setting is. So it's a pretty neat tool, I have to say. Again, read and write, read and write. This is all working very, very well. Okay, 13.2 is now what I have, the latest as I made this video.